first position is going to sit just shy of the top.
Yeah.
Not quite the top, so that when she goes down, she's got some nice support here. Now, she's light, she's controlled, strong. I don't have to, but I just have my foot here. Okay? So, I'm going to let her roll back. Now, because you're all teachers, you can, that's right, straighten out those legs. Now, she's little, so she can't touch. I'm going up here, she's going on the ground and push it, but you can move that, all right? And then she pushes nicely against the barrel. Okay? Now, this next one will adjust. You'll be more to the top. Now, I'll have, yeah, thank you. She can do this with or without a helper, as long as you have one. Now, this very often, because I've heard a lot of teachers say that, they can feel this better. It's different, but better. They get the straight back better. They feel the side to side better than they even do there. So very often, changing where you do this sequence is helpful. Identifying something you couldn't feel very well with that. So let's go. Up. That's right. Up. And that's right. And that's right. Thank you. feels good, it's nice, nothing wrong with doing it. It's just that in general, clients don't do it. And if it's a larger person, a guy, you do have to hold on to it. It's a little scary to have all that weight going on there. But in general, some clients love it because they can go if they have the chance to go further down, especially those that are taller, if you're a little restricted on